Hello everyone. In this video, I'll be discussing the proximity sensors. In order to get the previous video, please do click on the I button. And also I'll be putting up the video link in the description box also. Let's understand the concept of proximity sensor. What is the importance? How does it operate? What are the types of proximity sensors available? For example, you can able to see the proximity sensor, which is available in the form in the market. Okay, you can able to get the data sheet, everything. Let's understand what is a proximity first. Proximity in the sense to detect the object. So what is a proximity sensor? It is a device to detect the object. Okay, so let's understand the definition of the proximity sensor. A proximity sensor is a sensor able to detect the presence of a nearby object without any physical contact. Okay, to identify an object without any physical contact. A proximity sensor often emits an electromagnetic field or a beam of electromagnetic radiation. It may be either infrared or any other types. And it looks for the changes in the field or return signal. Majorly, it is focusing based on the principle of electromagnetic radiation. It emits electromagnetic radiation, and based upon that, it will identify whether the objects are nearby or not. How it is going to operate, I will tell you later on. The object is being sensed is used to refer as the proximity sensor's target. There will be an object which is considered as a proximity target. Okay, target and object. Different proximity sensors targets demand different sensors. It varies, depends on the requirement. It is going to vary. What type of object you want to sense? What type of object being sensed? Okay, that is depending on the material. It may be metal object or it may be non-metal object. Anyway, these kind of sensors are most popularly used for sensing the metal objects. So there are different type of proximity sensors are available. Most of the proximity sensors are suitable for sensing the metal object, but some kind of proximity sensor such as capacitive type proximity sensor that is majorly used for identify the presence of non-metal objects such as plastic. Even photoelectric proximity sensor is also available. That is also usually detect for the presence of non-metal objects. Okay. So inductive type proximity sensors are always used for identify the presence of metal object. So these are the basic introduction about proximity sensor. Presence of, it is the device which is used for measuring the presence of nearby object. Identify the object which is nearby. So that's the main goal of the proximity sensor. How do you classify proximity sensor? You can able to divide the proximity sensor into three. That is eddy current type proximity sensor, capacitive proximity sensor, and inductive type proximity sensor. Both eddy current proximity sensor and inductive type proximity sensors are similar. These two, like inductive type as well as eddy current type proximity sensors, are used for detecting the presence of metal bodies, where the capacitive type proximity sensors are majorly used for presence of non-metal such as rubber, plastic, etc. So these are the classification of a proximity sensor. Right now, let's understand how does eddy current type proximity sensor operate. First of all, I would like to identify the diagram. So this diagram is regarding eddy current type proximity sensor. So this is an object which need to be identified. Presence of this object need to be identified. This object will be metal type. It's a metal object. Okay, it is a metal object. As I already told you that there won't be any physical contact. Now let us look at the proximity sensor part. This is a right side you can able to see. This is a part of proximity sensor. It is having both sensor coil and a reference coil. Okay, it is imagine that this is a 2D diagram. Just imagine in a 3D manner. And you need to pass a continuous current through the coil, both reference and sensor coil. You have to pass continuous current. Okay, you can able to see the coil. So you have to pass continuous current through the coil. Whenever continuous current is flowing through the coil, what is going to happen? The surrounding area, there will be the formation of magnetic field. So surrounding field will be getting magnetic field. Okay, for example, surrounding area that is actually getting magnetic field. Magnetic field will be generated in the surrounding area. Look at this point. Like this, magnetic field will be generated. That magnetic field will be directly interacting with the conducting object, metal object. According to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, the EMF will be induced, and induced EMF that will be generating in the metal part. Due to induced EMF, which is generated in the metal part, there will be a formulation of continuous circulating current, a continuous circulating current which will be flowing through the metal part. That is called eddy current. So presence of eddy current will be identified in the metal object. Okay. So what that eddy current does? Because of that eddy current which will be passing through the metal part, because of formulation of eddy current in the metal part, the eddy current that will distort the main magnetic field. Where is the main source of magnetic field? Sensor coil is the main source of the magnetic field. The coil will produce the magnetic field, but the eddy current will distort the magnetic field which is produced by the coil. At that time, the impedance is getting varied. The impedance of the sensor coil that is getting varied. If you connect the changes in impedance to a particular switch, the switch is getting operated. According to that, it changes in impedance, switch will be operated. So this is the way how eddy current proximity sensor operate. Detailed explanation have been written over there. I have written entire explanation regarding how does eddy current proximity sensor. In conclusion, the ultimate goal of eddy current proximity sensor is to detect the presence of metal object. Current is continuously passing through the coil. Magnetic field is produced. Magnetic field is interacting with the conductive object. This results induced EMF. Due to induced EMF, there will be continuous circulating current over the conductive object. The eddy current which is produced from the conducting object, that will be distorting the field which is produced by the coil. This results the changes in impedance of the coil. The changes in impedance will be directly connected to the switch or any type of devices, actuator, such a way that it will activate. So that it will identify that, or buzzer or alarm, some kind of alarm, so that alarm will be activated. Thus, we'll identify that there is an object which is nearby to the sensor. This is the way how eddy current proximity sensor operate. Major advantages are given below. Eddy current type proximity sensors are cheap, available in small size, reliable, sensitivity is very much high, and you can go for the small displacement, measurement of small displacement. And also, various applications are as follows: automation field, then machine tool monitoring and assembling, then measuring the dynamics continuously for the moving target, and identify the vibrating elements. And it is used in automobile field, especially drive shaft monitoring, vibration measurement. These are the various applications of eddy current proximity sensor. Remember that this type of proximity sensor is applicable only for detecting metal objects. How do you detect non-metal objects, especially plastic, rubber, etc.? Yes, there is a solution. You can go ahead with the capacitive type proximity sensor. It is having two plates. The first plate is object itself. The object will be directly connected to the first plate. The second plate is known as sensor plate. In between, you are going to keep the dielectric medium. Usually, we consider air as a dielectric medium. Suppose if the sensor plate is always fixed. It is always fixed. But the object plate, that is usually varying. Suppose the object plate is nearby the sensor plate. The distance will reduce. The gap distance will be reduced. As you know that C is proportional to A by D. Okay. So from this I can write, as the distance decreases, what is going to happen? The capacitance will be increased. Capacitance will be increased. So that means if the capacitance value is getting increased, means we can understand that the object is very near to the sensor. Okay, we can identify the presence of object in this manner. So this is the way how capacitive type proximity sensor operate. So it is mainly used for measurement of the presence of object near to the sensor. Now I would like to discuss about another type of proximity sensor. It is known as inductive type proximity sensor. Our ultimate goal is to identify the presence of metal object. And you can able to see the sensing element of an inductive proximity transducer. It comprises of LC oscillation circuit. So inductor capacitor, inductor is connected parallel to the capacitor. There will be a signal evaluator. It is a signal processing device. Then switching amplifier, and the output can be amplified, recorded for the reference purpose. Okay. Now you can able to observe the inductance. You are going to provide the supply to the inductive coil. This results, there will be production of magnetic field. You can able to see the magnetic field. Magnetic field. There will be always a magnetic field. Because inductor is there, you are going to provide the supply. So this magnetic field will be interacting with the object. Due to that, inductance will be getting varied. Inductance of the coil. This is your coil LC. You can able to see the coil. Inductance of the coil is getting varied. Okay, inductance is getting varied. You know, the voltage across inductor, V is equal to L di by dt. So as the inductance changes, the voltage is also getting varied. Okay, whenever any changes in the voltage in the inductance, we will come to know that object is very near to the sensor. So the signal can be amplified. You can pass through the signal evaluator. Okay, signal evaluator is available. So we can output of the signal evaluator will be connected to switching amplifier. Thus, the signal can be amplified. According to the signal, we will identify that the object is nearby or far away. Because inductance changes, that will be directly proportional to changes in voltage. That signal will be passed to the signal evaluator. It will accept only a suitable band. The output of signal evaluator will be connected to switching amplifier. Signal get amplified and it will be processed afterwards. According to the nature of signal, you will identify that whether the object is nearby or far away. So this type of proximity sensors are generally called as inductive type proximity sensor. It is majorly used for presence of metal objects. What are the major advantages of proximity sensor? Ensuring higher reliability, long lifespan, and there is no moving part, so that wear and tear can be avoided. It is suitable for all the type of environmental condition. So it ensures high environmental adaptability and a resistance against the dust and dirt. Capable of versatile metal sensing with the help of inductive as well as eddy current type proximity sensor, and a considerably cheap, no moving part, I already explained, and it ensures long durability. It is durable. This type of devices are more durable. If I talk some setbacks of proximity sensor, regarding the distance, that is one of the constraint factor. The lack of detection range, that's a problem. Averaging a maximum range of 80 millimeter, above that it is a problem. So it can detect the metal objects. Mainly it can detect only metal objects. But the plastic object and all, it is somewhat difficult by using the eddy current type and the inductive type proximity sensor. But there is a solution for measurement of presence of object by using capacitive type metal proximity sensor to identify the presence of non-metal objects. But that is rarely used. So that is one of the setback. Performance can be affected by external conditions, obviously. The temperature, then cutting fluid or chemicals. So these are the major setbacks of proximity sensor. However, for every type of transducer, there will be pros and cons. What are the major applications of proximity sensor? The applications are as follows. So it is mainly used for identifying the machine vibration. And you can able to use in large machines. And you can able to use the proximity sensor in steam turbine, compressor, motors, etc. to identify the position, presence of nearby object, etc. It can be used in smartphones and laptops. Whenever your presence is nearby, the laptop will be automatically activated, especially your smartphone you can able to see. Whenever your smartphone is near to the ear, the light will be automatically off. When it is far away, you'll be getting the light. Okay, that is called the application of proximity sensor. That is one of the application. And also it is used in your car, in your vehicle, parking sensor. It will detect the presence of object nearby. Immediately you'll be getting alarm. You'll be getting the indication. Then conveyor system, that's also very important. Then food processing industry and security systems. So these are the various applications of proximity sensor. And malls and all, we are going to use the proximity sensor. Once the person is getting inside, automatically door will be opened. Okay, these are the applications of proximity sensor. In this session, I have discussed about what is proximity sensor, what is proximity, what is the word meaning proximity, and what is proximity sensor, types of proximity sensor, then applications, advantages and disadvantages. Let me know if you are having any queries. Finally, thank you very much for watching this video.